Hello, Dream Flights. So I'm here to do a much needed diabetes update. It's been a long time. How many of you are parenting a type 1 teen? Henry is almost 14. Like, how is he almost 14? You remember when he was 2 years old, poking, testing his blood sugar? And oh, it's been a lot of years. But things are actually going really, really, really well. Like surprisingly well. Like his numbers have been just so stable for quite a few months now, like nights and I don't know, just all the time really. We've been having really good luck and we have not been fighting with any durable medical companies or insurance. Like life has been so good. Our insurance as of January 1st just started allowing us to get our Dexcom G6s from the pharmacy. That is the slickest thing. I love it. It's so easy. Our insulin, like we just got 7 vials of insulin yesterday. Guess how much we paid? $140. Like that is so cheap compared to when we first started, years ago. And insulin was so expensive. I mean, we used to pay $200 just for like a couple vials. Like we got 7 vials for 140 bucks. So that is really great, because they had, I don't think that's just a Minnesota law. I think that's everywhere, right? That insulin, I'm pretty sure that's a, it started in Minnesota, but I think everywhere in the US is capping insulin prices. So now we just need to get Dexcom and Omnipods, like our pumps and our CGMs affordable. That's kind of the next step, I think. So yeah, so we got our G6s. Our Dex comes from pharmacy now, which is amazing. We're done with Edge Park, which is like we could have a party because we're so happy about it. It's just the best news ever. They were awful. Byron was awful. We struggled for years and years and years with durable medical. And now, so Henry's on the old Omnipod, the Eros, and they're discontinuing it. So now our pharmacy is just started to, we just got notification that we can get the Omnipod 5, the new pump, with through pharmacy. So it's scary, but at the same time it's exciting. I don't know. I don't know. I worry about it because our numbers are currently so good. Like his numbers are so good and we're very aggressive with our numbers. Like we keep a tight, I think that's the word really. We have tight control. That's what the word I'm looking for. And I worry that we're not going to have that tight of control on the Omnipod 5. But at the same time, I'm listening to the Juice Box podcast. I have one more episode left, the third one. I've done 2 hours and I have one more hour left that I'm learning about it. And I think if I really ramp up the carb ratios and stuff and this insulin sensitivity corrections, I think we'll be okay. So I'm praying that we're gonna be okay. So that's in the process. I just started that process of getting the Omnipod 5. What else can I tell you? Oh, we're gonna have to get a meter too. We don't want to keep using the PDM, the old PDM. Henry is really good about everything. Like he obviously gets really annoyed when he's high or whatever. And when he was little and he's like slamming the table because he hates testing his blood sugar, like honestly, he's the same. He just had to test his blood sugar like 2 days ago because it was in the 2 hour warm up and we were eating. And he's like, oh, great, of course, I'm gonna have to test my blood sugar right before supper or whatever. And he's like, oh, he acts like it is the worst thing in the world testing his blood sugar. It's cute because he's just like, he's the same as he was, only like a grown-up version of that. And who likes testing their blood sugar? Like nobody. But it's just cute because I'm like, oh my gosh, he has not changed at all with the whole testing blood sugar. But he's really good about giving insulin and unless he's at school with his friends, otherwise he's really good all around. Sorry, it's like noon. I think it's gonna ding like 12 times. So he's really great about taking care of his blood sugar. Unless he's at school with his friends, like when they're like at lunch or something, like sometimes he can get like forget to give insulin, like if he's in the middle of a class and somebody's handing out suckers or something, like that kind of thing. He will forget once in a while, but really he's real, the control is amazing. Like his number, like right now he's 73 stable, and he's been that way for hours. I'm very scatterbrained here, but that reminds me of, that's a worry of mine. Like he's 73 stable right now, but if he were on the Omnipod 5, the lowest you can go is 110. That's the, I don't know what I'm talking about. That's the, like, that's the level. Like it'll right now it would stop the basal to get him up to 110, right? So anyway, I don't know. It's just my gut tells me just to go for it, and we're gonna go for it. So it'll be a learning process, and maybe I'll share that process with you, or switching to Omnipod 5. As far as teenagers using insulin, insane amount of insulin. His breakfast ratio is like one unit for every three carbs or something. Like it's crazy. He gets a lot of insulin. And that is super typical for growing teenagers. He is over 6 feet tall right now, so he's very tall, growing, and that's all very normal. So, and his A1C has been awesome for years. Like, everything is going so well. Things are really, really great. But as a mom, as parents parenting him, it is so hard not to feel naggy. Like, I'm always nagging on him. Did you do this? Did you correct? Did you do this? Do this, do this, do this. It's like, you know, it gets, I try not to, but I can't stop myself because I want that tight control for him. And I need to stop like being so on top of things. Like I need to let him take more control over it. And he does well, but it just, you know, I don't know. I'm just not ready to let that go yet because it's important to me that he has good numbers. School is going great. Like we lucked out with school. Is 100% just I'm the nurse and that's just what we do. He never goes to the nurse. So that's kind of unique, and I think part of it is just because of where we live. Up where we used to live, we could have never done that. Every single thing was like an issue. Him having glucose tabs on him was an issue. Him having his bag with him was an issue. Everything was an issue. Him testing his own blood sugar was a big fight that I had to have a big meeting about in third grade. No, third grade? I don't know. And then we moved here to this, it's like a totally different land. And they were like, oh my gosh, that would be so awesome if you guys just do your thing. And that is, they're thrilled. Like they love it. And they have no worries at all about it. And the teachers are great. Everybody's been great. Everybody's great about it. So it's just really crazy how different areas are. You know, we're in a rural farming community and it's just very chill here and I love it. So I filmed like three lunches randomly of his, and I think I'm going to put them at the end of this video in case you're interested. And if you have any other questions or anything you want to ask or me to talk about, let me know. I can certainly make another video or do a day in the life or something if Henry's up for it. So yeah. Thank you for watching. Bye. Here is Henry's lunch for tomorrow. He saw this Planet box that he used to use when he was in like kindergarten and first grade, and he said he wanted to use it again. So I packed his lunch. That's why I packed it in this. So he is having a turkey and cheese provolone sandwich. That is 28. I should get the calculator actually. Okay, I'm gonna count 16 for the fruit. Carrots, what should I count those as? 10. These I'll count as 15. Jolly Ranchers, I have no idea. I'm gonna go 8 total. So 77 carbs. I'm trying to not overdo it because he's been going low every day because he has gym class in the afternoon, and being a little less, I don't know, less aggressive on his lunch has been perfect because I really don't want to change anything. So that is his lunch for tomorrow. For lunch today, Henry is having one of these two good yogurts. It's three carbs, and some granola, which is 37, a serving of almonds, which is four, I'm counting 10 for the carrots, 3 for dip. I did 3 for ham, and there's 3 for this sugar-free Jell-O. And he is having a Gatorade Zero. That's what's for lunch today.